What's up, everyone? I hope you're all well and you're able to handle the summer heat. I hate it with a passion. Anyway, this is another episode of Best on Every Album, where I give you my opinion on what I think the best song on every artist's studio albums are. This episode is on John Mayer. I try to keep these episodes limited to artists that have less than 10 or so studio albums because I don't want the videos to be too long, and John Mayer is within the golden zone, having done 8 studio albums so far. I also thought about doing 2-part videos for artists with more than 10 or so studio albums, as well as for current artists that I do a video on that make new studio albums. It's very possible I could do a part 2 of John Mayer because he could have the next 30 years to make albums. We'll see, but first thing is first, and that's John Mayer's first 8 studio albums, so let's get started. John Mayer's first studio album is Room for Squares from 2001. It went to number 8 on the Billboard 200 and sold over 5 million units worldwide. The 3 singles on the album are No Such Thing, Your Body is a Wonderland, and Why Georgia. Now, this is a great album in my opinion. If you don't like his style of music, that's fine, but he's a damn good songwriter and a great guitar player, and he definitely knows what he's doing. It's incredibly hard for me to pick the best song off of this album, and there aren't any songs that I don't like on this album either. The songs that really shine here for me are 3x5, 83, No Such Thing, and Why Georgia. I was never really into Your Body is a Wonderland that much because it's just extremely overplayed, and maybe I'm just sick of it, or it just repels me because it was marketed nonstop. The lyrics are also pretty juvenile. I still think it's a good song, but it's not my favorite on the album. The song St. Patrick's Day has a ton of chords in it. That's something you hardly ever hear today. Neon is a great song with a great guitar lick. Why Georgia has a really interesting guitar part, and the lyrics are much deeper, questioning his life and decisions that he's made. And I love the use of dynamics throughout the song, going from the verse, chorus, and bridge. When Mayer uses introspection in his songs, it makes me much more interested. 83 is a song about reminiscing about a life that doesn't exist anymore, and no matter how good you seem to have it with your current situation, sometimes you long for simpler times. Here I Stand, 6 Feet Small is also a great lyric in the first verse. 83 also has some interesting percussion going on. This song is a perfect mix of music and lyrics to me. No Such Thing is a lively song and pretty much has the same sentiment of a few of the songs on this album, reminiscing about the past. This one's about carving your own path out of high school and not listening to all the adults telling you to go from point A to point B in a certain way. There's also a lot of color in the chords of this song. If there's one thing you could count on, is some really good guitar work in a John Mayer song, and this has it. Like I said, it's incredibly difficult for me to pick the best song on this album because I feel like it's just splitting hairs. I like so many things from all the songs that I already mentioned, and even songs I didn't mention, and that goes for most albums with the artist I choose for this series. I think I would have to go with the song 3x5 by a smidge. It just does everything right, and the lyric, "Today, skies are painted colors of a cowboy cliche," is just a great lyric. 3x5 is a great metaphor for not living your life through a photograph, a postcard, and experiencing it with other people instead of just living in the moment and actually experiencing it. It's almost like going to a concert and recording the entire thing on your phone instead of just being there living in the music. It fits perfectly with this face in a screen generation. Put the damn phone down when you're outside. The music in 3x5 is kind of frantic, but it pairs perfectly with the emotionally sound melody and lyrics. There's a lot of color in this song with the chords, and that's why I choose 3x5 to be the best on the Room for Squares album. Today, skies are painted colors of a cowboy cliche. Next, we move on to John's sophomore album called Heavier Things from 2003. This was John Mayer's first number one album on the Billboard 200 because he put out such a good debut album in Room for Squares. Heavier Things sold over 3.3 million units worldwide. The singles on this album are Bigger Than My Body, Clarity, and Daughters. There are a lot of songs on this album that I like, but I can find something in them that I don't love. Nothing wrong with that, obviously. Every song isn't gonna wow everyone. Most of the songs on this album have that cool John Mayer soft rock blues type vibe, but there are some songs that seem kind of generic or don't have the best lyrics in the chorus. I know a lot of people like the song Clarity, but it just doesn't move me as much as the other songs. I like the song Daughters too, but maybe just like Your Body is a Wonderland, I've just been beaten over the head with it. The songs that I consider to be above the rest on this album are Bigger Than My Body to a little bit of a lesser extent. It's a fun song and the more popular of the three that I narrowed it down to, but it's not really a typical sound of John Mayer song. But I ultimately whittled it down to New Deep and Split Screen Sadness. New Deep is a song that goes places that you don't think it's gonna go, and it still works. The chorus is really good, and it seems incomplete when it gets to the end of it, but it magically works. Someone who knows more about music theory can explain that one, because it's an abrupt transition, and you think the logical thing is for it to keep going, but it doesn't. A lot of people don't like this song, but I do. I find what Mayer does in the chorus and the end of the song is just creative and experimental in a good way. Split Screen Sadness has great melodic phrasing, a relatable topic with a story that progresses, and great lyrics. I've always loved Mayer's phrasings with his melodies, and this song is great at it, in my opinion, with a lot going on. The strings also add more of an emotional feeling to it, and because of all of that, Split Screen Sadness is my choice for best song on the album, Heavier Things. All you need is love is a lie. Now we come to John's third album, Continuum, from 2006. Continuum came in at number 2 on the Billboard 200 and it sold over 5 million units worldwide. The four singles are Waiting on the World to Change, Gravity, Dreaming with a Broken Heart, and Belief. The song Say was added to the album 2 years later, so I'm not including it in the discussion. In my opinion, the album Continuum is as flawless as it gets. As much as I like Room for Squares, I like this just as much or even more. There's only one of the 12 songs on this album that I don't love, and that's the cover of Bold as Love by Jimi Hendrix. The other 11 songs could all be singles in my opinion. They're just that good. They might not be your cup of tea, but they're definitely worthy of praise. Musically and lyrically, it's a perfect album. From the guitar work on songs like In Repair, Belief, and Waiting on the World to Change, to the more somber, heart-wrenching songs like Gravity, Slow Dancing in a Burning Room, and Stop This Train. Also, I could be wrong, but his voice work on Continuum seems a bit more airy and less gravelly than the previous two albums. I like both versions of John Mayer's voice, but it kind of opens up a new side for him to give to fans. I can't really pick a song on here that's the best per se, but I can give you my favorite song on the album, which is pretty much the best song on the album in my opinion. If I asked people what their favorite song on this album is, I'm sure I'd get tons of people picking each one of the songs on this album. The song that gets to me that's the most emotional for me is Stop This Train. The song that gets me into a certain mood with the message and where I admire his guitar work and the bridge the most is Belief. But the song that I like the most overall on this album is the incredibly smooth song, Slow Dancing in a Burning Room.
I was the one you always dreamed of. You were the one I tried to draw. How dare you say it's nothing to me? Baby, you're the only light I ever saw. I make the most of all the sadness.
You'll be a bitch because you can. You'll try to hit me just to hurt me, so you leave me feeling dirty, cause you can't understand. We're going down, and you can see it too. We're going down, and you know that we don't. My dear, we're slow dancing.
Next is the album Battle Studies from 2009. Battle Studies is John's second number one album and has sold over 2 million units worldwide. The four singles are Heartbreak Warfare, Who Says, Perfectly Lonely, and Half of My Heart. Battle Studies is a good album, although I don't think it's on the level of Room for Squares or Continuum. I'm not sure he could ever revisit the type of success Continuum is, so that's not a knock on the album, and some of the songs on here seem like Mayo was flirting with country a bit. Nothing wrong with that, but just an observation. Half of My Heart with Taylor Swift and War of My Life are definitely country-tinged. My favorite songs on this album are Edge of Desire, Perfectly Lonely, and Heartbreak Warfare. The most fun song on the album for me has to be Perfectly Lonely. The guitar riff in the beginning and throughout the song is great, and it's just a great vibe. It's a really good pop song. Heartbreak Warfare is lyrically great with such vivid imagery with the heavy topic, but the music contrasts that pretty nicely with a light YouTube-like vibe. It's kind of similar to their song Pride in the Name of Love with the music. Edge of Desire is kind of a sexy, smooth song in the same vein of slow dancing in a burning room in a way, and it's about longing for someone. The bridge really showcases that longing with the guitar work. It also has some contradictory lyrics like A Tiny Infinity, A Dream That Keeps Waking Me, Silently Screaming, and Wired and I'm Tired, but they all work well together. Like I said before, John Mayer is a hell of a songwriter, and this is another song that proves it. Edge of Desire is what I think the best song is on Battle Studies. Born and Raised is Mayer's last number one album from 2012 so far, and it sold just shy of about 700,000 units worldwide. The three singles are Something Like Olivia, Shadow Days, and Queen of California. I have to admit that I haven't listened to every album from Born and Raised on until doing this video. This is the time when it seems like Mayer's popularity and record sales started to wane. Mayer himself has stated that he wanted to start experimenting with new musical ideas after Battle Studies. I can understand that desire, and of course, any artist can put out anything they want, but the faithful fans are probably going to take a step back at that point. His first four albums are what the fans love, and I'm sure they wanted more of it with just slightly more variation. I didn't even have to listen to this album to know that it was going to be different from his previous work. I knew this was going to be a country album after Battle Studies, having a couple of country light songs on it, and after reading that he wanted to experiment from then on. It's not a huge departure from the blues, because country is a cousin of the blues, but there's a little too much twang in this album for me. It's my least like John Mayer album up to this point. This album is a project where the artist is doing it mainly for themselves at this point, for their own artistic curiosity. I mean, that's always the case with an artist to a point, and it's fine, but now it's just solely experimental and for the artist's own validation. I understand that some artists get bored with doing the same material over and over again, and I'm sure there are fans that would love an artist's songs, even if they sang nothing but gibberish and played a kazoo, but I kind of feel that artists have to balance that artistic curiosity with what brought them to the dance in the first place. So why am I going on about this? because although John Mayer is still showcasing his undeniable talent on this album, there are hardly any songs on here that really satisfy me as a listener. I hope I'm not being too harsh, because who am I to criticize, but for the purposes of doing a video where you're judging an artist's work, it's necessary. It's not like I think it's a horrible album, but it's just not what I'm super into. There are John Mayer fans that love this album, and I've even seen some of them say that it's his best yet up to this point. I just don't see it. I love all types of music, and this just doesn't do it for me. Maybe it'll grow on me. What can I say? I wouldn't actively choose to listen to any of the songs on this album again, though, but I would have to pick from either Whiskey, Whiskey, Whiskey or Queen of California for the best song on this album. To me, both of these songs are John obviously describing himself and his music and the lifestyle that comes with it and who he's had to be in a way up until this album. It seems to me that he's soul-searching in this album and is writing music he's probably always wanted to write for a while, but those record obligations and fan expectations have held him back a bit. Queen of California is a more commercially viable song, but Whiskey, Whiskey, Whiskey edges out the other songs on this album for me. The lyrics, we pick up in New York City to try and find the man I never got to be, and the only deal I ever signed, no devil drew a dotted line, the stage was set, the words were mine, I'm not complaining. Is him saying, yeah, I wrote what I wrote in the past on my own volition, and I'm not complaining about the music I've done, but now I'm changing, and I don't want to continue doing what I did in the past four albums and that part of my life. Whiskey, Whiskey, Whiskey is a simple yet effective song in conveying the emotion that Mayer is putting forth here, no matter how anyone interprets the lyrics.
We pick up in New York City, I'm trying to find the man I never got to be. But when I pushed down on the pavement, I found the whole thing so much harder than it seemed. The only deal I ever signed, no devil drew a dotted line. The stage was set, the words were mine, I'm not complaining. Whiskey, 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 water, 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 sleep. Whiskey, 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 wake up, shake it off and repeat. It's just a phase, it's not forever. It's just a phase, but I still might have a ways to go.
Mayer's next album is Paradise Valley from 2013, which came in at number 2 on the Billboard 200, and it sold about 600,000 units worldwide from what I could find. Paradise Valley is his worst showing in terms of sales since his debut album Room for Squares. It was more understandable then because he was a brand new artist that nobody knew anything about. Paradise Valley is his 6th studio album, and after Born and Raised, I all but expected Paradise Valley to drop in sales. The 3 singles are Wildfire, Who You Love, and Paper Doll. This album is pretty similar to Born and Raised, to my delight. It's slightly less country this time though, but still not my cup of tea. Again, there's nothing on here that wows me. I like the song about Taylor Swift called Paper Doll. I even like Who You Love, even though a lot of people don't like it much. I narrowed it down to I Will Be Found, Lost at Sea, and Waiting on the Day. They're pretty similar songs with deeper lyrics and similar tempo and vibe. Either one of them could be my pick for best song on this album, but I'd pick Waiting on the Day. I Will Be Found differentiates itself from Waiting on the Day by adding some piano, but I think I like Waiting on the Day a tiny bit more.
Waiting on the day when my thoughts are my own, when this house is my home and plans are made, when you'll be there for me, baby. When you love me all the way, when you take my side in every little firefight, when you hang your things and stay. I'm waiting on the day.
The next John Mayer album is The Search for Everything from 2017. It also made it to number 2 on the Billboard 200, and it sold just over 600,000 units worldwide. The 3 singles are Love on the Weekend, In the Blood, and still feel like your man. This album seems like John was coming off of his country kick and returning back to the old John Mayer with his blues and soft rock approach. There are still a couple of country-tinged songs on this album, but not for the most part. I hate the name of the song, Emoji of a Wave, but I like the chorus, and In the Blood is probably the song with the best lyrics on the album. However, it came down to Helpless, Rosie, Still Feel Like Your Man, and Moving On and Getting Over for the best on the album for me. Helpless kind of reminds me of the Rolling Stones a bit with the guitar work, and I like the lyrics, and the guitar solos are very satisfying. Moving On and Getting Over is another smooth, laid-back song. Most of the songs on this album are, but this one kind of has an air of urgency when John uses staccato at the end of the verse melody, which makes it more interesting. It also has a Marvin Gaye vibe to it. Still Feel Like Your Man is probably the most funky, liveliest song on the album, and it has a B.B. King sample from the song How Blue Can You Get. Also, check out the music video to see John Mayer dance with people in panda suits. Rosie is pretty smooth, but it's pretty much a song about showing up drunk on an ex's doorstep and asking her to let you in to have sex. The only thing she should be doing is calling the cops, sir. It might be my least favorite of my favorites on this album. These are pretty much all similar songs, but I would have to say that the best song on The Search for Everything for me is Moving On and Getting Over. It's just smooth, jazzy, has a great groove throughout the song, and it's really diverse, hitting you with something new the whole time. And the phrasing is, of course, excellent. Of course it is. It's John Mayer.
Tell me I can have the fact you loved me to hold on to. Tell me I can keep the door cracked open to let light through. For all my running I can't understand, I'm one text away from being back again. But I'm moving on and I'm getting over. I'm getting over. So long, it just goes to show you that I still can't seem to get you off, get you my off mind. And I sure would like to see you one more time.
The most recent John Mayer album and last album in this video is Sob Rock from 2021. It also went to number 2 on the charts, and it sold over 520,000 units worldwide from the most recent numbers I could find. This is Mayer's last record with Columbia Records after 21 years, as he decided to not renew his contract with them as he continues to explore new avenues in music. The 6 singles are New Light, I Guess I Just Feel Like, Carry Me Away, Last Train Home, Shot in the Dark, and Wild Blue. That's a lot of singles to have on like a 10 or 12 song album. I'm not particularly fond of any songs on this album. This is Mayer's attempt at his 80s soft rock album, but it doesn't have any of the charm or color of 80s soft rock. This is just a generic soft rock album for the most part. You might be saying, well, who the hell are you to judge? I agree. I'm just telling you how I feel about this album. It's fine if you love it, and I don't mean to be harsh, but I'm sure John Mayer doesn't care about my opinion anyway. I don't know why, but the song Wild Blue is giving me a Dire Straits Sultans of Swing vibe at the beginning, and like all the songs on this album, it's very laid back. All I Want to Be Is With You has a nice guitar solo at the end, but it has a more country feel than an 80s feel. Why You Know Love Me, and yes, you heard that right, Why You Know Love Me is the epitome of why this album is called Sob Rock. It's 4 minutes of John sobbing with very minimal straightforward lyrics in the chorus with an equally sobbing guitar. I can tell you that this is probably the worst song on the album. Last Train Home gives me a Toto vibe, probably because of the synth and drums being used, kind of like in the song Africa. Like I said, none of these songs do much for me, but if I had to pick, and I kind of do, I would say the best song on the album Sob Rock is Last Train Home, simply because it reminds me the most of an 80s soft rock song in Toto.
If you wanna roll me, then you gotta roll me all night long. If you wanna use me, then you gotta use me till I'm gone. I'm not a fallen angel, I just fell behind. I'm out of luck and I'm out of time. If you don't wanna love me, let me go. I'm running for the last train. I'm running for the last train home.
All right, so that's my best on every album for John Mayer. Some bad in my humble opinion, some good, and some great. I'm sure there are going to be a lot of disagreements with my choices, and that's fine. This stuff is all subjective for the most part anyway, especially with an artist as technically great as John Mayer. I honestly think he's one of our generation's best songwriters and musicians. Hell, I think he's one of the greatest in both categories for any generation, and I love his sound voice-wise and guitar-wise as well. So tell me what you think of John Mayer's best songs on all of his albums, and I'll see you in the next video.